side of it like this, right? So the first.
So you go here. So we're gonna kind of set up, start setting up our seatbelt grip, but we don't want to set it up all the way yet. It's gonna be hard. It might be hard for us to move our hips. Okay. So as we're kind of just reaching like this, we're gonna switch our knee. This knee is gonna go on the inside here, and the back foot is gonna step behind his butt. Okay. So here, my knee goes in. I want it to go on the inside. You can't have it on the outside. Okay. Kind of keep this hand here. This one you can control the belt or whatever, but you want this hand here ready to fix your seatbelt. Okay. Your back foot is now going to step over their near side leg, near side foot. Okay. Now you're going to fall at a 45 this way, so you want to set your seatbelt grip up nice and tight. Once you get your seatbelt grip, your chest comes right to their back here. Don't let it move. Don't let them turn and you don't turn. Okay? So once I'm here, boom, I set my seatbelt grip up. Everything's nice and tight. And I want to aim for my head to be somewhere in this area here. Okay? Now I fall this way. Okay? As I fall, I'm going to pull his heel towards my butt. Okay? That's going to kind of bring him with me. As I pull this, I kick my bottom leg through. Oops. Here. Okay? So now here. Got my bottom hook in, and I can use my top leg, scoot my butt back, throw in my hook, and now I make sure I have good pressure here. So kind of doing like a row here, you want to use your big muscles, instead of just kind of squeezing using your biceps and stuff, use your back. Push, squeeze your chest into his, elbows close to your sides, kind of like you're doing a Heimlich here too, here, and then your head is important. You want your head over their shoulder, and pushing down into hips. So I'm going to go like ear to ear, pushing my head into hips. Once you get here, go ahead and move around a little bit, Kelton. You want to maintain this. You don't want to let him try and sit or jump back, or his head on the back, or the toes on the back. You want to try to maintain the forward hip. If he starts turning, his hips face up, then we're going to come here. Then you bring it back. Then you can even keep this here if you want. Force is going to go. Turn front and see if it's in there. Okay? So that's just a little bit of back control. Okay, so boom. We can take it. And switch. Boom. Over. Okay. Pull this. As you call it. Pull. Now the bottom is scoop up. Focus in. Hook here. Nice and tight. Head here. And move around for a few seconds. Control. Okay. Any questions on that? Pretty simple back take. Combine that one, or we'll do these two. The other one's pretty much the same. But here, the grips are a little bit different. You're here, boom. Same thing, you switch. But instead of stepping over, when I get here, my knee's on the inside. I'm gonna grab his far foot. Okay? Now, same thing, I'm gonna go over that 45 degree, pull his heel into his butt. Okay? So, come in this way.
Here, hold this now. I'm gonna try to pull this in. Sometimes, you know, his leg is in the way. So, I pull that down. Focus. So, here, I pull it down, then I throw my leg over. Okay? Same thing. Set up your seatbelt grip.
Okay. One more time on that one.
Here.
Switch. Knee comes in. Grab here right away. My hands here. Lead 45. Pull him up.
What your hooks in? Bottom hook first, whatever. Top hook first, that's fine, but try to get them both in as fast as you can. Find the space to get your way through.
Boom, here. Hook, you can hook your chin, or you can just go ear to ear and keep everything nice and tight. I like to have this belt grip a little more towards their armpit instead of straight in their sternum. Right now, if I was straight in the sternum, I'd have to make space with my arms. So I'm here. And it feels tight. Here. And then the
arm's pretty much all the way through for a choke. So the deeper you get this, right there for a choke. Any questions on that?
Why would you go for one of those groups over
the other? The foot or the... So sometimes when you're here, and you're going for this, they have their ankles tucked in nice and tight, and you can't step. But you can always do this. When you're here, whoop. So sometimes, you know, if you're able to catch them right away, I like that one. It's one of my favorites because it's so hard to stop this. Because if you're here and they're starting to pull your leg, your hip's going to go no matter what. They have to give you their hip this way, and then the bottom hook comes through. The other one, you're tucked in. It's close to the same, but you're pulling their opposite leg up for the butt. They're not doing anything. So, yeah, usually can't move that. Straight before. Yeah. We good? Any other questions?
Yeah, on the when you have the back and you're using the your legs to flip the hips there, like they're trying to walk out on you. We just kind of go over that there, how to use that.
Yeah. So, if I have both of my hooks in here, he wants to get his back flat. You know, preferably he wants to go this side, on the weak side, but there's still a stage, you know, if he's able to get his back flat, even if I have this, I don't have a choke. Even if I still have this around his head, flat, I can't show them. I'm going to express often as you go down. Okay? So, to prevent that, you know, they can only turn their hips or their shoulders, you know. They control one of that. So, if I have a really nice seat belt grip here, it's going to be hard for him to turn his shoulders. So, he's going to start with his hips. And once his hips go, it's going to make it easier for him to turn his shoulders. Okay. So once he starts turning his hips, I want to stop. I want to lock that and turn him back toward it. Okay. You can even use this as a control. You don't have to necessarily use it as like a landing planner. You can be here and just here. And just push him, keep him turned away. You can stay out here, cross your feet over your hip here.
The pressure with your top foot on the hip itself.
Right here?
Yeah, with the right foot on his
right
hip.
I'm crossing my feet. Over the top of the hip. Or
just push here.
Oh, you can push here on the back too.
Down in there, or just for control. Or...
You can do that too. I like to go behind the knee, preferably. I like to start turning. It's a little bit better leverage. You can turn it around the top. Always think about this. Push it.
Keep it a twist in their spine so they
can keep it in the shoulder. Once his hips turn this way, now it's just a matter of time for the shoulders. Unless I have a super strong, tight here, I don't want to burn out. You know? So here, I got the borderline burn out to keep him from, you know, not turning the shoulders. But I'm not controlling it. But if you have a really good control of your seat belt, there's no reason why you shouldn't be able to maintain that. Even if he turns his hips and goes flat, I have this super tight, put my shoulder behind his head. It sucks. I don't sit him up and start looking to take him back again. So, okay, we'll roll.
Yeah.
Any other questions? All right, let's break off, get that those two back plates done, and then we'll go over now. Front roll this way. Okay, what it's going to end up doing is my shoulder is going to push against his head, and it's going to force his head down. It's going to make him need to roll with me, okay? It's really important that you have a tight seat belt right here. I can't be loose with this, okay? So basically what I'm thinking about doing is putting my shoulder and doing a roll around this way, okay? If you do it slow, it's not going to look completely right, but I'm going to do it slow so you can see what I'm doing, okay? So I come to here. I put my shoulder against the back of his head, and I start rolling. Now, I'm gonna bring my body around this way so you guys can see what it's doing to him. Okay? And you can actually do it this way too, you can roll, as long as this is really tight. Okay? And it's gonna force him to roll this way. Okay? But when we do it slow,
he's not gonna land on me. He's gonna land in between my legs when I do the fast.
And when you do it, when you do the roll, you kind of fold them with your arms, your seatbelt grip into his chest, and you kind of stuff them in between the legs. Okay? I'll do just a little bit faster. So this is nice and tight. You can hear the roll. Throw your hooks in, and then you bring your toe. Now that's kind of a gi and no gi version. The straight gi version, you're gonna come two hands underneath, grab your pelts really tight. And you basically do the same thing, you just roll and pull the pelts. I don't like this one as much because you don't have control over there. You're not making it tough. By pulling this and rolling, you're kind of making it tough, but you're not forcing his head down. I think with this one, it's better to do. If you're making them, they have pretty much no choice. Okay. So one more time. Here, make sure this is nice and tight. Okay. Roll your shoulder over. Try to put your shoulder here, but you don't slide. I see a lot of people just slide off, and you don't want to do that. Keep your chest glued to his shoulders.
Okay.
Stuff it in between your knees.
Okay.
On your shoulder, you kind of do like a shoulder pull. Okay. Boom. You can. I've seen it done where people run their body around too. But. Okay. Boom. Stuff it. So once you roll, push. Here, push into their chest. Stuff them in between your legs. Okay? Can we get on that? It'll take a little bit of getting used to, but first one on the bottom,
make sure you cut your head.